In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to roll a short put option, including when is the right time to roll a short put option up, sideways, and down. I'm going to show you my real life examples of each one of these situations. This will help you understand how you can use rolling short put options to consistently put cash into your pocket every single month. I'm Randy Perez. I'm a 22 plus year stock and option trader, as well as real estate investor. If you're already a member of our community, thank you for setting aside a part of your day to be here. If you're not a member of this community, go ahead and click that subscribe button and bell notification so that you'll never miss the free stock and option education that this channel is committing to providing for you. I'd like your input on something really important. What is a stock or option topic that you would like to be discussed in a future video? In the comments below, let me know what subjects you would like discussed in a future video. And stay tuned until the end of this video where I will share with you where you can find information on how to receive details and alerts on all of our actual trades. Briefly, what does it mean to roll a short put option? Simply put, rolling a short put option is done when you have sold a put option and you like to extend the time in the trade. In order to do that, you buy to close an option that you have sold short and sell to open a new option in the same company or ETF. This is generally done simultaneously as one order. Here you see an example of a short put option that we rolled last week in Tyson Foods, ticker symbol TSN. You see in the blue box that we bought to close the January 15th $65 short put option. That cost us a little bit over 88 cents per share. As you can see in the red box, at the same time, we sold to open the February 19th that same strike price of $65 put option and received $3.08 per share. We felt comfortable rolling the same strike price out or sideways for another month because as you can see here on the daily chart of Tyson, the stock was pretty much at the exact same price that it was at the previous month when we initially sold the January $65 put option. It was still trading right around $65. This roll trade put $2.20 net per share into our pocket, and it was actually one of our two best trades that we did last month. If you annualize the return that we received by rolling out this put option, if we stay in this position until the option expires on February 19th, we'll have been in this position for 35 days. That annualized non-leveraged cash-on-cash return will be 35%. If you're curious, the return on the margin requirement of $2,490 for this position is actually a 276% annualized return on margin. So as you can see, just like selling put options, rolling short put options can be very profitable. But what if a short put option position has gone against you and the short put option you sold is now in the money? When is it the best time to roll a short put option down in strike price? Here you see a trade we did in 3M. On October 14th, we rolled the October short put that we had sold at the $165 strike price down and out to December and $160 strike put option. As you can see in the red box, we bought to close the October 18th $165 short put option back, and that cost us $4.48 per share. We simultaneously sold the December 20th $160 put option and received $6.73 per share. Notice that we were able to roll our short strike price down by $5 because we went out 2 months. Also, since we went out 2 months, on top of rolling the short strike price down $5, we're able to collect a credit of $2.25 per share. Now, why do we feel the need to roll this short put option 3M down? Notice here on the daily chart that 3M had been making lower highs and lower lows. It was in a clear downtrend on the daily chart. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you know that I always like to look at multiple time frames when I'm analyzing a position in a trade. Here you see on the left a copy of that same daily chart in 3M, which shows that it was indeed in a downtrend on the daily chart. If you look over at the chart on the right, the weekly chart, you see another reason why I wanted to roll my short $165 strike price put option down. 3M was also in an overall downtrend in the weekly chart. Then to make 3M's outlook even a little more negative, if you look at the bottom of the weekly chart in the yellow box, the down weeks in the red bars had a lot higher volume than the up weeks in the green bars. All these factors and indicators put together helped me decide that I wanted to roll that short put strike price down. Now you might be asking, well, why are you trading in 3M anyways if you think that it's heading down? And that's a legitimate question. The reasons are that I believe 3M was a solid company. I liked the price it was trading at, and I believe it was trading at a discount, which as you can see on the weekly chart, just from January of 2018, it had declined almost $100 or 38%. Back in January 2018, it was trading for close to $260 per share. And now in July of 2019, it was trading for around $160 per share. I like 3M as a company, so I actually wouldn't have minded if the stock had been put into my account. Obviously, I prefer to keep playing the option game by rolling options, but Ethereum had been put into my account, I would have just started selling call options against it, as well as collecting the dividend that 3M pays. But going back to our situation, at that point, I believe that 3M might continue to head down, so I wanted to roll our short 165 put option down just in case 3M continued to decline. And we were able to do that by going out 2 months in time while still putting $2.25 per share into our pocket. If a stock has moved against you and you believe that the decline will continue, if you don't want the stock assigned to you, then it'd be best to try and roll the short put option down in strike price. If I feel negatively about a stock's price movement, I will go farther out in time than just 1 month to roll that strike price down. I always like to roll options for a credit, but if I feel negatively about a position, then I'll even do it for break even to put the position more in my favor. But what if the stock has moved so far against you that even when you go out in time, you still can't roll that strike price down for a credit or even a break even? The answer is that at that point, it's decision time for you. Personally, all the stocks that I trade, I'm prepared for them to be put into my account. If a stock moves against me in such a big way that I can't roll the put option out or down for a sufficient return, then I'll let the stock be assigned to me. Then if it's a dividend paying stock, I'll begin collecting the dividend and at the same time begin selling covered call options against the stock to keep that cash flow machine producing cash. If, however, you're not in a position to have the stock put into your account, then you want to make sure that you still have some time value left in that short put option. Once that time value is down to almost nothing, you have to make a decision. You're either going to have to roll that put option out sideways to buy yourself some more time, or if you can't roll it down for a credit, roll it down for a debit, or just take a loss and close the position out. The other possibility, though, is to actually switch the position into a long leap option position. If you'd like more information on how we use leap options to generate awesome cash flow returns, check out the video series Leap Options at the link above and in the description below. Next, I'm going to show you when is the right time to roll a short put option up. But if you're liking the video, why don't you do me a favor and tap that thumbs up button? It helps let me know that this is the kind of content you want to continue seeing, and it helps support the channel. And stay tuned until the end of this video, where I will share with you where you can find information on how to receive details and alerts on all of our actual live trades. I think this is something you're going to want to see, as we have consistently put over $10,000 a month into our pockets over the past several months by selling options. So we talked about when is the right time to roll a short put option down. However, when is the right time to roll the strike price of a short put option up? Let's go back to our 3M example, but now let's fast forward in time about a year. Here you see 3M's chart over the past year and a half. Notice that after the big drop in March, 3M has pretty much been heading up by making higher highs and higher lows. As such, we have felt comfortable rolling our short put option strike price up, as you can see here on the screen. In fact, as you can see in the blue arrows, we've rolled our short strike price up from $135 to where it is now at $175. In all, we've raised our short put option strike price 5 times. When I'm trying to decide if it's the right time to raise a short strike price put option or not, I look for evidence that the stock is showing strength, just like 3M is here. When a stock is continually making higher highs and higher lows on good volume, you can be pretty comfortable that it's in a solid uptrend. If you decide to roll that short put option up, just make sure to sell put options with strike prices around those new support areas. And that's what we've done here in 3M over the past 10 months. If you'd like more details on how I go about rolling put options, including how I go about rolling put options that have gone deep in the money on me, check out the video in the link above and description below entitled How to Roll Over Put Options when this video is finished. At the beginning of this video, I told you I was going to share with you where you can find information on how to receive details and alerts on all of our actual trades. There are actually 2 places that you can find information on all of our actual trades. At the end of this video, there will be a link to a series of videos entitled Option Trading Monthly Cash Flows. In those videos, I show every single trade we did in that previous month in our main option trading account. I then highlight and talk through several of my favorite trades that we did that month. That is a totally free way to see all of our trades, as well as the thinking behind several of my favorite trades that we did that month. If you'd like to receive live alerts of our trades as soon as we make them, check out the benefits of becoming a patron at the link in the description below. You can choose to receive weekly, daily, or even live alerts of all of our actual trades. Our patrons also get a list of stocks every weekend that we plan to buy outright or sell options on. We take a lot of the hard work out of finding option trading opportunities, as well as provide information on why we entered those trades. And a quick shout out and a big thank you to all of our current Patreon members. Thank you so much for your support. Check out the videos in the link above and description below, where I share with you the actual cash flow we received, as well as every trade we did over the previous month. Until next time, happy investing, and we'll see you again soon.